G'day viewers, going to have a little bit of a rant with you today about the media and how they're shit and how they lie all the fucking time. And I'm not even going to go for any of the big political issues where it's obvious they're lying and serving vested interests. I'm going to make it a bit more personal, bring it down to a personal story and one that maybe might open your eyes about why it's a good idea to not take media reports at face value. Now, when I say it's a personal story, it isn't about me personal, but it's about an ordinary person like you or me. Someone I know through YouTube had the unfortunate experience of being attacked in his backyard by a crazed druggie. This guy was on ice. If you don't know what ice is, crystal meth, crack, basically the drugs that make people do the crazy. This guy had been menacing the neighborhood generally, and he burst into this guy's backyard where my friend was with his mother, and was very violent and threatening and scary as all fuck. And in self-defense, her friend fought him off with a knife. Didn't kill him, didn't cut his throat or anything, did stab the guy. Just as in a get the fuck away, not like a holding him down, just to make the guy go away. And it worked, and the guy went away, ambulance was called, and he's carted off. And then the media reports came out, and how the media reported was, like, my friend is an attacker who stabbed a victim. Yes, the crazed druggie bursting into the yard and threatening violence upon people is the victim. Now, I'm sure the media would offer their defense that what they said was factually true. The druggie was on the receiving end of a knife, which made him a stabbing victim. There's a complete omission of a huge number of really pertinent, true facts about self-defense and crazed, drug-fucked freak boy attacking innocent people. But hey, what does the media care? They got their scare story about a stabbing attack and the victim carted off. Just think about that for a minute. You've been through what's hopefully the most traumatic experience in your life. Hopefully you haven't had anything worse than a crazed junkie attacking you and your mother. So you've been through that, you've protected your family, the people closest to you, and then you see media reports calling you the attacker and the crazed druggie the victim. I mean, seriously, and this shit, in terms of how media reports things, goes on every day. So my point was not so much that my poor bloody friend, or that, you know, a bit of solidarity out there for someone who needs some support. But when you see media reports and they paint things in terms of black and white, because they almost never go into shades of grey, just think, oh, it might not be true. They might be lazy. They might have vested interests in painting this a particular way. They might just be lying. Who knows? For shits and giggles. Now, I'm probably pushing shit uphill with this because I get contacts from people all day who believe insane shit because they read it on the internet. And in theory, media outlets have a bit more rigor than that. But they still lie all the time. And that's what it comes down to. Not that they make mistakes, although they make mistakes all the time. Not just that they reprint press releases from politicians and big companies and pretend that's reporting. They do that too. But people, reporters, media outlets lie. Whether it's a lie of omission or a deliberate fabrication of story, it happens all the time. If you take media stories on face value, basically they're making you their bitch. So do yourself a favor. Just when you see media reports, just always keep in the back of your mind, this might not be true. In theory, they're a bit more reliable than a bloke in the pub, but sadly, it's not always true.